Hello friends, we had seen brief overview of the Six Sigma approach in the last video. Now it's time to learn each phase of the Six Sigma along with various tools and concepts used in each phase. The defined phase is the first phase of the Six Sigma improvement process. In this phase, the project team creates a project charter, a high-level map of the process, and begins to understand the need of the customer of process. This is a critical phase in which the team defines the project, that is, focus for themselves and the leadership of the organization. Let's see first defined phase tools and concepts in Six Sigma. There are multiple tools used in defined phase of the Six Sigma to define the problem and area of focus to reduce the losses. They are like project charter, project plan, surveys, Kanban analysis, A3, SWOT analysis, and many process maps like SIPOC, process flowchart, functional deployment diagrams, and many more. We are going to study these tools in sequence, starting with project charter in detail. So let's begin. Project charter. The project charter is a live document and used to clarify the process issues being addressed as well as what is not being addressed. We are calling it as a scope of the project. It is the first step in the Six Sigma project and therefore takes place in the defined phase of the DMEC. The project charter is periodically reviewed and refined throughout the project. A project charter generally has common elements to complete defined phase of the project. Let's see them one by one. First, problem statement. Sometimes the hardest part about being a problem solver is choosing which problem to fix without jumping to a solution. Teams usually begin by fixing what bugs them, but ultimately the best projects focus on improving customer satisfaction. A problem statement is a concise description of the issues that need to be addressed by a problem solving team and should be presented to team or created by the team before they try to solve the problem. The 5 W's can be used to spark the discussion about the problem. The problem statement will be an answer of the following questions. Like, what is wrong, not working and not meeting our customer needs? Where and where do the problem occur? What is the frequency of the problem? And what is the impact of the problem on our customer, business or employees? For example, the average lead time for the process is 55 days. This is based on the historical data of the last 1 year. If this will continue, we could lose a major customer, resulting in a potential revenue loss of $2.5 million. 2. Business case. It is a justification for the proposed project or undertaking on the basis of its expected commercial benefit as against investments. The business case should address these questions. Why is the project worth doing? Why is it important to do now? What are the consequences of not doing this project? How does it fit in with business initiatives and targets? What is the financial impact of the project or problem? And what is the investment needed to complete the project? For example, as we see in the problem statement about the excessive lead time of 55 days, this project was initiated to eliminate the problem of poor customer response. One of the items on the business balance scorecard is to improve this performance. We have to take this project on priority, otherwise we could lose a major customer, resulting in a potential revenue loss of $2.5 million. 3. Goal statement. The goal statement must be SMART, which is an acronym for specific, measurable, achievable or attainable, relevant and time bound. Specific means what exactly will you do? Measurable means how will you know if you meet your goal? Achievable means what steps are you going to take to reach your goal? Relevant means what about your goal make it important to you? And timely bound means when do you want to complete your goal? For example, continuing the same example of the lead time which we had considered in the problem statement and business case, let's prepare a goal statement. The goal of this project is to reduce the lead time of the process from 55 days to 20 days in 6 months of time, with starting date of the project as 1 February 2018. 4. Project scope. Project scope is defined and specified project beginning and end points. The more specific the details, that is, what is in scope and what is out of scope, the less a project may experience a scope creep. To define a project scope, you must first identify the following things, like project objectives, goals, sub-phases, task, resources, budget, and schedule. For example, let's continue the same scenario of excessive lead time. We need to identify lead time product-wise to determine if any particular product category is having a higher lead time. If we can find out a product category X is having a higher lead time than all other products, then we can limit the scope of the project to category X only. Here, we can say in scope, product category X, and out of scope, all other products. Similarly, you can find out if this higher lead time issue is with some operation or resources. Sometimes, budget amount is smaller compared to the investment required to complete the project. In that case, we have to divide the project in phases with well-defined scope of each project. 5. Team members. Successful projects are usually the result of careful planning and the talent and collaboration of a project team members. This portion of the charter talks about the key individuals that will be the part of project planning and implementation. A. Six Sigma expert as a coach. There must be one Six Sigma expert to coach the team in planning as well as implementation according to the difficulty level and importance of the project. B. Project champion or sponsor. The project sponsor is the driver and in-house champion of the project. They are typically members of the senior management, those with a stake in the project outcome. They obtain budget or resources for the project, accept responsibility of problems escalated from the project leader, and approve charter. C. Project leader. He is responsible for planning, implementation, as well as closure of the project. D. Team members. They provide input and they are also responsible for completing action items as assigned to them. They are subject matter expert in different functions, acting together as a cross-functional team to complete the project. E. Process owner. They are responsible to sustain activities once the project is completed. Now, assign these roles and responsibilities to the team members in the project in this portion of the charter. 6. Timeline or milestones. As we know, Six Sigma project works on the DMEC approach. At this portion of the charter, we have to define planned completion date for each of the phase, that is, define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. We also have to put actual completion date for each of the phase in front of the planned completion date. This is required to ensure that the project gets completed in defined timeline. As we are reviewing our project at each of these phases, it is also called as phase review or phase gate review to proceed for implementation of a next phase in the project after confirming that all activities in the previous phases are completed. 7. Project risk and issues. In this portion of the charter, we have to note down all possible risks, dangers, or potential problems that could lead to the failure of this project. For example, balancing improvements along with production priorities, upshift operator involvement, etc., etc. In this portion of the charter, we also have to mention contingency plan to resolve issues and reduce risk. 8. Project assumptions. This portion of the project charter explains assumptions we are operating under market, customer, etc. For example, no significant new development in technology to change our product portfolio, no significant new competition in the market, etc., etc. 9. Critical stakeholder. A stakeholder is any individual, group, or organization that has a stake in the operations of your business because of the possible effect your business may have on them. Employees, shareholders, customers, and clients are obvious stakeholders. And the last part of the project charter is 10. Project charter approval. In this portion of the project charter, project sponsorship team approves the project charter for leadership, resources, budget, defining success and constraints. They are the part of steering team of the organization like site head, operations manager, HR manager, process and engineering manager, quality manager, etc., etc. This is all about the project charter, the first and the most important tool in the defined phase of the DMEC. Now, share this video in your entire group to improve their life at professional level. Add your valuable comments and suggestions regarding it. I will be sharing such an important concepts in Lean and Six Sigma usually once in 2 weeks. If you don't want to miss such useful information on my channel, then click on the bell icon after subscription and select an option of get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.